loving kindness. Do something here. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we worship and give you thanks. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, cleanse me with the blood of Jesus from all unrighteousness that could hinder further blessings from reaching me. In the name of Jesus, please bless me with the blood of Jesus from all unrighteousness that will hinder further blessings from you from reaching me. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, let it be well with this nation. Prosper this nation. Help our leaders in this nation to do the right thing. Let me eat the fruit of the land. Open your mouth and pray. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please help me, every member of my family and friends, to make heaven glorious there with ease in the fullness of our time. Help me, every member of my family and friends, to make heaven glorious there with ease in the fullness of our times. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father, we thank you for this request that have been dropped in the course of the week in this morning meetings. Father, answer all of them. Amen. Turn this request to sweet testimony. Amen. We that are here and our brethren that are online that have their requests, that because of this stuff they can't come and drop. Father, turn them to testimony. Amen. Thank you, Father.
Thank you.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. God bless you. Please be seated. On Friday, we just had a few moments for testimony. If you are here, you have testimony very brief. If your own is long, don't worry. In the evening, you will do your job. But if it is very brief, God bless you.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
I want to thank God for the salvation of my soul. I want to thank God because this week, last week as I resumed to work, so many problems in the office. They started attacking one way after the other. But I thank God I came to pastor and he prayed with me and everything now. And I want to also thank God. There's a rat in my house that is always troubling me. On Sunday, I could remember the rat was disturbing in my room. I said, I went into another room to sleep. So and I said, that rat, it will die. It will not come out from that place. And I left. Same thing the next day, the rat was still there, disturbing. I moved to the other room. And I remember Tuesday, the word came from the other. I said, there's a rat that has been disturbing me. That rat will die. So I got the building on Wednesday, after the Wednesday morning, I went back home, I saw that the room, the rat was smelling. I said, okay, now all of you will now die in that room. So I just want to give God the glory, because the next day, that's on Thursday, I didn't come back home. And yesterday, that's on Wednesday evening, I didn't come back home. Yesterday when I go home, I didn't even see one rat moving the hangar. Praise the Lord.
Amen. God bless you. Is it the Lord that?
Praise the Lord. I want to thank God for the salvation of my soul and for every member of my family. I want to thank God for joining mercies all through the festive period. My dad had a full house, and by the special grace of God, all of us will come back to our parents and kids. Praise the Lord.
Glory be to God. Who did all this?
Jesus.
Oh my God. Wow. Let's lift our hand to our brethren that the testimony that they have given to not come back as prayer requests again. They are already sealed and permanent. And we that have heard their testimony in different areas of our life that we need visitation, God will do it for us. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Every rat, Holy Ghost, praise the Lord. We are going to be talking about building your oil reserve. Building your oil reserve. One of the most painful things that can happen to a person is to almost get something And when you get to the point of getting it, something happens and story is being told. They call it near success syndrome. It can be very painful. When somebody has been holding on for a thing and getting to the end, discouragement comes and the person steps out and another now steps in to receive it. It is very painful. Meaning that the person did not have the grace or the oil or the tenacity to get to the very end. Because there are some blessings or reward that you don't get until you get to the end. You will do all the efforts will be rewarded at the end. Hence, if a person has been putting so much effort and it now does not get to the end, it will now appear as if all the efforts wasted. Matthew 24:13. The Bible says that it is those that will endure to the end. But he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. It is a bad thing. And that is usually because of insufficient oil in people's life. Near success syndrome. Some people call it almost getting a mission, almost getting married, almost getting the job, almost getting the contract, almost getting pregnant, almost getting to the time that the delivery will come, almost getting the visa, almost every spirit of almost in your life that have been frustrating all your effort. Today, the power of the Holy Ghost will remove and destroy. In the name of Jesus. Almost getting your healing. Whatever it is that terrible spirit has been in place to frustrate, today God will remove that. That was what happened to Moses. Very painful. Anytime I read the story of Moses, it scares somebody because you know how upright he was for a long time, but he now got to a time as if the oil had run low. He now started making mistakes, making utterances. Started abusing the people that he took time to pray for when God said, let me destroy these people. What that means that time that God wanted to destroy them, he said, go, why do you eat? The other nation will say that you are not powerful. The oil was intact that time. But when the oil ran low and it went to empty, he was the one, the people he was trying to shield, he was the one not causing them. You stiff-necked people, shall we bring water? And God was not happy with it. And God now told him to climb the mountain. He climbed the mountain. God said that, see the promised land. Your eyes will see it. You meaning that they are war to the point of now they could see it. Deuteronomy chapter 34, 1. And I said that what is this thing that makes a person to try, and you will get to the point of entering something. The thing will now not happen. And Moses went up from the place of Moab onto the mountain of Nebo to the top of Pisgah that is over against Jericho. And the Lord showed him all the land of Gilead unto them. Don't go to 4. Verse 4. And the Lord said unto him, this is the land which I swear unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, saying, I will give it unto thy seed. I have caused thee to see it with thy eye, but thou shalt not go over that. I can just imagine how he would have felt. He would have done reminisce all the things he went through, I prophesy into your life. The spirit of nearly getting something that is precious, let that spirit that is aborting the process be destroyed in your life. Everything that you are on the journey of getting, you will get this year. In the name of Jesus Christ. That is when the oil reserves are run low. Insufficient oil makes the fire to run out in the course of burning. Well, maybe I will read the scripture that will drive home this truth unto you so that you understand what I'm saying about the 10 virgins. Matthew chapter 25, 1 to 13. Matthew 25, 1 to 13. You will read the account there and you will now understand what we mean by building your oil reserve or sufficient oil. All the virgins, virgins mean that they kept themselves. Virgin means that you are a believer, but it's not enough to be a believer. The lamb, the Bible says that the word of God is the lamb. That means that it's not enough to know the word and practice the word, but you need the oil, the Holy Spirit. With all that you do the word, practice the word, believer, that may not take you to the very end of the promise, but you need the oil. Then shall the kingdom of heaven be likened unto 10 virgins, which took their lamps and went forth to meet the bridegroom. And 5 of them were wise, and 5 were foolish. You know, some people will be thinking that the way we come to care of every time speaking to them, they will not know by the time that this will be in the course of the year. It will be too late to start making it on that time. But the people that are talking, they have put the reserve and they're able to cry two different things. They that were foolish took their lamb and took no oil with them. But the wise took oil in their vessel with their lamps. Why the bridegroom tarried, the host slumbered and slept. And at midnight there was a cry made, behold, the bridegroom cometh, go ye out to meet him. Then all those virgins arose and trimmed their lamps. And the foolish said unto the wise, give us of your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answer saying, not so, lest there be not enough for us and you, but go ye rather to them that sell and buy for yourself. And why they went to buy? Some people in June, they say, we are not be praying, don't see all the problems now. They are not in care people. That time. And why they went to buy? The bridegroom came, and they that were ready went in with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. Afterward came also the other virgins, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said, verily I say unto you, I know you not. Then he now gave the advice, the candid advice from heaven. Watch therefore, for ye know neither the day nor the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh. Now you are praying every time. Yes, do you have any problem now? We know that we need to build a reserve. The oil in this picture is the Holy Spirit in the realm of the Spirit. Because when you read the scripture, anytime that there is olive oil being released upon a person, you will see the confirmation of the Holy Spirit in the realm of the Spirit. Just like David, in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 13. 1 Samuel 16:13. The Bible said that when Samuel anointed him, what happened? The Holy Ghost came upon him from that day. So, oil in the realm of the Spirit is the Holy Spirit. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And what happened? And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. Physically, oil was released on his head, but spiritually, Holy Spirit, meaning that Holy Spirit is actually the oil of God upon a person's life. When they're talking about Jesus Christ being anointed, you know what they said? They did not talk about physical oil. in Acts chapter 10, verse 38, that how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with what? With the Holy Ghost. Meaning that the oil of God, because when you are talking about anointing, is oil, you used to anoint. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good. He did not get tired. And healing all that were oppressed of the devil. But God was with him. It's painful to start something, and when you're about to get it, you fizzle off. You lose it. You have been giving yourself, and you get annoyed. And the person that is watching, that has been sent to help you, just watching to give you something, and the person just withholds it. You never knew that something would have been released to you. But you just went off at that time because the oil has run low. So we need to constantly build our reserve. How do you build your reserve? By speaking in tongues. Jude 1:20. The Bible says that you build up your reserve by praying the Holy Ghost. But ye, beloved, building up yourselves on your most holy faith. Doing what?
Praying
the Holy Ghost. Do you mind if we quickly do 1 or 2 minutes of that right now? Let's rest our feet and just say, Father, thank you for your oil in my life. As I open my mouth, grant unto me divine utterance to build my reserve in the name of Jesus. Mashinti de Bile Kushukul Baba. Ibile Kishikilwa. Keep us stirring him up in our lives in the name of Jesus. So that the flavor people will be seeing concerning us will be that of sweet and beautiful one. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let me know that offering and bless the name of God.